Welcome to the last section in our series on protein. This section will be covering protein energy malnutrition. We're going to start by looking at kwashiorkor. And this is an example of a child with kwashiorkor. Kwashiorkor has an acute onset, and it generally occurs when the mother's pregnant, has another child, and starts breastfeeding the newborn and all of a sudden stops breastfeeding the child. What this results in is a sudden halt in protein consumption by the child. So it does happen all of a sudden. They might be switched to some sort of grains, and although they may be getting enough calories, there's generally not enough protein. One of the characteristics of kwashiorkor is the swollen belly that you saw. It's covered up now, but you saw in the initial picture. But also, you know, look at these swollen feet and swollen legs, considering how thin the arms are. And this is because of a fluid imbalance. Remember when we talked about protein functions? Proteins are very important in maintaining fluid balance. And proteins do a good job of keeping fluid in the bloodstream. It's not in the bloodstream, it's going to leak out into the surrounding tissues, accumulate around the abdomen, and then in the lower extremities, the legs, ankles, and feet. Another reason that the abdomen may be distended is because of a fatty liver. The other type of protein energy malnutrition is called marasmus, and this child here has marasmus. Now this starts generally immediately after birth, so the child is born, but there's just not enough food. It could be that the mother is breastfeeding multiple childs or doesn't have enough breast milk, but there's also not enough of other types of food or grains to feed the child. So this starts after birth, but it's a little bit more slow to develop. It's not that acute start as the kwashiorkor is. I do want to point out that it's a deficiency of calories in addition to protein. Not getting enough of any of the nutrients. And it creates this matchstick arm look, really, really thin arms. You can see the ribs are showing through here. The face is generally sunken. You can usually see a lot of the cheekbones. They tend to look like little old men, these children. So again, one of the more important points about this is that it's a lack of protein and calories. Starting immediately after birth, these children, this is an older child, but a lot of these children don't survive. Kwashiorkor is that lack of protein, but they do get calories. So they do have longer survivals, but it's that acute onset and deficiency of protein. So make sure you are able to differentiate between these two types of protein energy malnutrition. And this is the end of our series on protein.